What is up, everybody? In this video, we're going to be doing something crazy. A run consisting of the 7 From Software Souls and Souls-like games all in a row without getting hit a single time. The games included in this run are Demon's Souls, Dark Souls 1, Dark Souls 2, Bloodborne, Dark Souls 3, Sekiro, and Elden Ring. If I get hit at any point in any game, I have to restart the entirety of the run. This is a run requiring a ton of patience, consistency, and game knowledge. And it feels to me like the culmination of all I've learned about these games over the past 6 years of playing them. Make sure you hit subscribe if you enjoy runs like this one, because there's going to be a lot more in the future. But for now, you can relax, and I hope you enjoy this monstrous run. Order of games, descending difficulty. It's ascending consistency is what the order is. Solar, thanks for the good luck, dude. That one was pretty bad, but I guess I gotta aim more left, I guess, man, because straight through.
Oh my god, how on planet Earth did that miss? Oh, and I got poisoned.
Yeah, it's weird, dude. My Bloodborne early game has been really good a few times I've played it recently. What I expect for Bloodborne is that we have a chance of getting hit on shadows, and then the rest of the run should be good. That's what it should be. Personally, don't care for it in a run like this. That's like me, but for Sekiro. I like Sekiro and stuff, but Sekiro really does not belong in the God Run 3, in my opinion. Or it doesn't belong in a Souls game multi-game run. And I remember at the time where I was kind of deciding what to do. Yeah, this is in great positioning here.
The sweet blood. Oh, it sings to me.
See if that works or not. Actually, kind of good that he jumped in. No, Cam. I don't know why people are saying Cam is broken. My Cam is not broken. Just I got a new one. I ordered a new one and it hasn't arrived yet, and I basically just removed my entire previous cam setup, so yeah, it's nice. We're not gonna have any of those cam glitches anymore that I used to have. So it's gonna be a huge upgrade on the quality, and then also it's not gonna be broken. Theoretically. I'm actually really excited to see how it's gonna look. I if somebody told me like 3 years ago or 4 years ago when I was streaming that eventually I'd be buying some decently high-end camera for my fucking face cam, I would not believe them, dude. Do I think a first time blind playthrough of Elden Ring with no deaths is possible? I mean, I guess theoretically, yeah. Rant Sekiro without being spotted? No. I have not done a lot of runs in Sekiro. When it came out, before preparing for the God Run 3, the last time I played it was when it came out, and I was the first person to no damage that game on a couple of the endings, and I had not played it since. It's one of the problems with, you know, how, you know, me going for this run is that my time in the Souls games is very... I guess the God Run 3 games is very imbalanced. Over half of the time I've spent in all the Souls games combined is in one game, which is Dark Souls 3. Oh, really? You had to go right next to the wall, huh? Don't have a wall instance.
people have a different idea of what replayability means, and I personally think that's just not right. All right, new strat time, I guess. Please don't. Fucking asshole. Really curious how the timing's gonna work out here. Kind of funny if the strat just doesn't even work at all. Beautiful. Hopefully that'll prevent that, like, super low percent chance meme that can happen there. Bloodborne boss. Now, there's a mechanic in this game known as the limb break stuff, where you can, you know, attack a certain point on a boss, on some of them, like the beast bosses, and if you deal enough damage to it, it'll break and cause a stagger, and then you can deal more damage to the limb that's broken. I personally enjoy the limb cuts, like are in DS2 and I guess DS1. Yeah, there is something coming up at the end of the month, which honestly I'm not super aware of the details, but all I know is that I'm going to be commentating in it. My first Souls game was DS3. I don't know. It's not the same. Back when we did those Elden Ring tournaments, back in like 2019 and before, or not Elden Ring tournaments, like Souls no hit tournaments where you know people are just running any percents and stuff. Most of the time, people would not no hit the games, which makes it way more interesting, right? But at this point, I think if we're supposed to get three of those, I think, for example, if we did an Elden Ring any percent no hit tournament. Every single player would just no-hit the game every time. Like, it just... Things are a lot different now. Which means you would have to get way more creative with the format. And yeah, like, that's why I guess Zero Hit League is interesting, right? Because it's totally different. Rando hitless. That's actually, that's interesting. The only issue with that, though, is, you know, when you're doing randomizer no-hit in Elden Ring, you're encouraged to just try to find a, you know, some sort of spell build. And so people could potentially be just looking for a build for, like, hours, you know? That's the problem with that. Yeah, just, and then, you know, it would end up just being too long. And I like the idea of that, though. Two people, they get the same seed, and then they have to do their best to no-hit. Whoever gets the smaller number of hits, whoever takes fewer hits moves on. Yeah, it'd be kind of fun to do, probably. Oh my god, this guy is just totally shadowing his friend here. Maybe he could do a time limit. Alright, one more of those, and then probably a couple bullets could work. Whoops. Actually, fine. We're just gonna shoot him a few times, get him a little bit closer to the threshold. The way our damage is set up here, it's really... I think I should look into getting an extra dex point, maybe. I think that'd make a big difference. That's probably good enough. Okay. He's honestly got a lot of health left, but another R1's probably too much. What do I do? So we'll just go for it. This fight right here is why Bloodborne should be game one, but... No, I can't beat that. Wow, this is just atrocious RNG, man.
My pellet wore off.
So, that's really bad. Unbelievable. An absolutely atrocious boss, dude. It's insane. Yeah, nice save though. Yeah, pellet actually wears out like exactly when I go for the transition, of course. I guess I should have waited a bit longer, but I thought I'd had a little bit more time on it. It's so funny, like I try to jump off there. But I guess maybe it's because there's like a slight drop or something, but it seems like in this game, whenever I try to jump, I don't. And whenever I don't try to jump, I do. I'm honestly running very low on vials here, man. Game have any good bosses? Not really in the any percent. Gascoigne's probably the best any percent boss. But yeah, so you really have to get to the DLC or some of the later... optional base game bosses to actually have any good fights here. There's a lot of multi-enemy boss fights, and there's a lot of screaming. Yeah, Nurse is okay. Bloodborne have the worst base game in terms of bosses? Well, it'd be hard to argue that. If you account for the time when the game came out, then like, maybe? But it's not like DS1 and DS2 are so great either. Bosses in the Souls games only really started to get in my opinion, something really special when DS3 came out. In terms of base game bosses, at least. Like, DS1 and DS2 are honestly, like, pretty similar. DS3 obviously is insane in the DLC, but it's still really good in the base game. But it's all about the DLC. That's what I'm pretty hopeful about Elden Ring DLC. Just a copy of Tower Knight. Yeah, it's like a garbage version of Tower Knight, honestly. Like an extremely garbage version of Tower Knight. He wasn't moving because we just kept limb breaking him. But yeah, Rom, we punch in the nose to build up Beast Beater. That's why. And that would be one of those questions that's on there. Why do you kill the doll? It's faster. Why does this frenzy thing not count as a hit? You know, that one I actually don't know. I don't know why, but apparently it just doesn't. The fuck was that noise? I haven't heard that before. What do I do on Gideon again? It's Charger 2, Backstab, R1, Charger 2, R1, L1, right? Pretty sure. Did I say Gideon? Yeah, I mean, they're basically the same boss anyways, to be fair. That's funny that I said Gideon. That tells you how highly I regard this boss. Right alongside there with Gideon. I think Gideon was literally, when I did the tier list, I think he was actually the lowest boss out of all the Souls games. This is a nice little strat I found. I found fighting, what most people do with Miko is they fight him in the room, and I find it kind of sketchy, so I looked for a strat to make it more scripted. Which the idea of this is that basically goes the same way every time. Backstab. R1, charge 2. R1, L1. In that case, he didn't do the tentacles, so in this case, we circle around. Yeah, average soul boss awareness, dude. Just like the character just walks in front of them, doesn't even care. I don't think the beast pellet really does anything there, but I don't know. I have so many extras, it doesn't matter. Oh my goodness, dude. Oh boy. I didn't mean to roll that last time there. It worked out. Yeah, I rolled to the right position and stuff, but it didn't look so nice. Man. She is loving that spin attack on this fight. What a boss, dude. Wow, that was not a good fight, but I'm not sure why when you kill the boss, it just nothing happens for like 25 seconds, dude. I wonder why they did that. Okay, so should we do... I guess we should probably do some DS1 next, right?
Hunt now.
There we go. We should probably do DS1, just considering, you know, I have no-hit Sekiro today. We know it Bloodborne now, but we haven't no-hit DS1. Certainly not my cleanest Bloodborne run right there, but it got the job done. What's interesting is there's actually only been one time where I've been attempting God Run 3, and I've no-hit all of Bloodborne, Sekiro, and DS1. Yeah, it's only happened once, and what ended up happening was I ended up losing the run in Demon's Souls, which at the time I had as game four because of a bad strat, basically. Three toughest. They're the three least consistent for me, for sure. Yeah. Yeah, hopefully, you know, hopefully next attempt I no-hit all those three games that we, you know, we kind of make it somewhere at least, like game five, game six, maybe get a little sniff of the run, but a slow climb, dude. That was a weird opening. Like, usually you don't get that attack. My DS2 SO1 is world record time-wise. I have no idea. I highly, highly doubt it. Like, 140 is very slow for that. Hardest part about these runs is definitely the mental side of it. Usually I do better under pressure, actually, but staying focused the whole time and, you know, being able to reset, be patient, all that stuff is probably the hardest thing. I actually haven't gotten hit in Sekiro today, but we started the day in DS1. I got hit on ONS. I did another run of DS1, also got hit on ONS. And then I redid Bloodborne, got it no hit, and now we're doing DS1. I believe that's what happened. It brings us to right now. Video proof the Lawnmower 4.0 won't cut your balls. Surely I'll provide proof of that. No, the run doesn't have to be in one sitting. Yeah, and in fact, you know, since it's already 4 hours into the stream, even if I did make it kind of far, I definitely wouldn't be able to finish it today, I don't think. I honestly do expect, I do think that there's probably gonna be a couple of attempts that make it far and fail, you know? Where we're actually in a position where we're like in Dark Souls 2 or Demon Souls or something where it's like, okay, very consistent games remaining. I'm probably gonna lose a run at least once in one of those three games. Getting consistent at these first three are gonna be, it's gonna make or break the God Run 3 for me for sure. Yeah, that being said, you know, I use like a hidden body route in DS3, and he probably doesn't want to use that, and sorcery route in DS1 and Demon Souls. So, yeah, any death in this run that isn't required, it counts as a hit and would be a reset. Smelter Demon health drain does count as a hit, yeah. Just for talking to a woman, just don't be an idiot. Very simple. Well, you can be an idiot and then... Wait, what was the advice I gave? Was it don't be an idiot? Well, I guess you just have to make yourself not an idiot then. Simply no hit a Souls game and then instant, you're just like flocked by women, dude. Trust me. That's obviously what happens. Especially if it's DS2. The ladies love DS2. Trust me. You have no reason not to trust me on that. Yeah, see, we got some confirmation in the chat, dude. I'm right. show her the Millennia dodge. Actually true, man. Show her how to dodge waterfowl and then you're good to go. On mosquito. It's interesting how in this game you actually need a certain amount of stamina to be able to roll. And I also no hit Sekiro earlier today, so. Dan, thanks so much for the donation, dude. I appreciate that. Oh my god. How did that even happen?
Gods demand repentance.
What happened, dude?
All of it.
That's what I get for like not paying attention for 1 millisecond. I was looking straight at the game. I didn't. I guess the boss is gonna like crouch down or something. Yeah, thanks so much, Dan, dude. Yeah, I would have died if it was the quick slash. I easily was dead there. Did she go underneath my arrow?
I'll give you the best.
Are people subscribing on Twitch or is this insane? I don't have my Twitch notifications up, so whoever's subbing on Twitch, I guess thanks for that. But
I'll give you the best nut ever.
That's so funny, dude. I guess it's not a bad thing. Maybe, dude, Twitch is gonna like ban me for that. Like, whoa, you're getting resubs on this site while streaming on YouTube? That's banned. Legends, dude. Well, yeah, so what happened is the shot missed, but then I wasn't really paying attention and I didn't expect it to miss. So I immediately shot the next one. But yeah, me being turned around for that didn't matter. Yeah. Okay, I see what you guys are saying. No, where it went wrong was the shot that missed. And then I wasn't paying attention and I queued up my next shot and that's very bad. And so I turned around. It actually, turning around probably saved me there, because it just delayed how quickly the boss could reach me. Full control. We've really had some weird things happen today so far, man. I don't like it.
Maybe.
What I might do though is alternate the platform I'm streaming on, probably. So just YouTube today, Twitch tomorrow, YouTube Wednesday.
Yeah,
and the classic thing where a streamer says to not do something when it comes to giving me money, and then they just do it anyways. Absolute classic. Oh yeah, they're saying to stop giving them money. Let's give them way more money than before. Yeah, thanks for subbing on Twitch, you guys. But like I said, you might as well just wait if you're gonna do it. Who's the first person who did that, man? They're getting banned. They sub to you, ban, instant. Don't even think about it. Somebody asked somebody asked, I think, if being calm is a streaming persona. No. But could you imagine a streamer where like they're fucking psycho in real life, but when they're streaming, they're just normal and super calm, and like that was their strategy for whatever reason? Doesn't sound like a good strat. Oh boy. Not a good streamer strat. Serial killer? Yeah, maybe, I guess, actually, dude. But yeah, thanks you guys.
Gods demand repentance. Cough up your coin. All of it.
Holy shit, he actually de-aggroed. That was insane. How'd he follow me so far? He's got caught in that fire. Died somehow. I only don't do the knockoff strat here because this weapon takes a lot of stamina to swing, and if I whiff, you're alive still. Yep, nice game we got here, dude. That's so weird. I've actually not seen that before. I wonder what happened, because I'm pretty sure he stood up earlier than he even normally would there. Not like using a plus 3 or 4 battle axe or something. I think it actually, man, this new speaker, I can hear so much more stuff happening in the game now. it's kind of funny because there were, you know, so many people ask me why I don't wear headphones and stuff. I hate wearing headphones and I like being able to hear what's going on around me. But there definitely have been times where, you know, the streams had audio issues or, you know, I get hit by something where people can hear it, but then I don't. But now that I'm on like a good speaker and not just some monitor fucking built-in speaker, it's so much better. I can hear everything, dude. But yeah, I mean, my mic definitely does not pick up a lot of sound. Like, and plus, of course, yeah, I got the right settings in OBS and, you know, audio interface also helps a bit with that as well, with like the noise gating and stuff. But the reason I went with this sort of setup is because, you know, hearing some other streams and you hear like controller clicks and all this stuff, I'm not a huge fan of that. Yeah, once I have my new cam come in, I'm gonna have like an actual professional streaming setup, dude. After 6 years of streaming, finally, I'll have a legitimately good streaming setup. The first time ever. Good internet, cool PCs, good sound setup. I don't know what else there is, man, but at this point, I might as well upgrade some stuff. I didn't get a new chair, but I really like my chair, so never had any issues with it. I guess it could be time for a new one because I've had this one for a long time, but it's still perfectly fine. Need to think of what else I could need in this setup I've got going right now, but I can't think of anything. I guess I've seen people have multiple cams. I remember Jerome. I guess probably most people don't know who that is here, but No Hit Jerome used to have you know, 3 or 4 cameras set up so that you could get a bunch of perspectives on, you know, his stream. Yeah, I could just have more cameras set up. Okay, hello? Please stop. Yeah, make sure I don't have cheat engine up. Yeah, surely, dude. Let's go on yogurt. I guess I could upgrade my mic setup. You know, I could definitely make it better, but there's not even a point at all. Yeah, I did get a dummy battery, yeah. I did all the research for it. That's what I did this weekend. My girlfriend and I researched on what cameras people use for streaming and how to get it set up, and you know. I think I got everything. So we'll have to see when it arrives and I try to set it up, but I believe I got everything. You know what? Maybe that's one thing I could probably improve is having lighting, but I honestly do not want to do that. I don't want to have a light blasting on my face all day long. Sounds horrible. I don't know. All this stuff that I don't remember. Let's go into prison. Dude. I heard a running noise right there. That wasn't my character. I think it was the Silver Knight like shuffling his feet or something, but it actually... All these extra sounds are scaring me, dude. I have not been able to kill this guy. Oh, just kidding. And that's always the solution. Always just say that something can't happen and then it just happens. Oh my god, you fucker. Why you guys gotta do me like this? Dude, this is crazy. Usually sorcery has a pretty easy phase one, man, but like we've just been getting really, I don't know if my timings are off, you know, three runs of DS1 and all the ONS phase ones have been atrocious like that. And that was probably the worst one. Use Great Heavy. I could use Great Heavy, but I don't really like committing to such a slow cast, honestly. They could. Not quite that bad. Still pretty bad though. Yeah, I also think a lot more people have premium on YouTube because it's just a much better subscription, right? Compared to Twitch Turbo, which is like the equivalent. Prepare your ears, and I get to listen to this on my new speaker, dude. Did you guys know that Miyazaki himself was the one who did the voice acting for that? For that sound specifically? That's actually true. And so they're like, well, that's really fucked up, but we might as well use this. Yeah, just like a primal reaction, dude. And I don't only really like them, I love them, and I need them. I'm underselling his enjoyment of barefoot, dirty barefoot ladies, dude. Come on, game, work with me. To be fair, though, to be completely fair, these Souls games do have a weird obsession with feet, dude. Like, that is undeniable. Hide your toes. Hide your toes, Miyazaki, dude. Where's the fiend's hero? I'm sure Emma's got no socks on, dude. I'm sure of it. I haven't looked, but I mean, just the maiden in black or whatever in Demon Souls, just right out of the gate. Yeah, and then you stomp her right in the face. Yeah, at the end of the game. Yeah, that's true. All right, let's get Soul Spears going. Kind of unfortunate that this route requires us to get two Soul Spears. They're so expensive, but you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. Oh, why am I? The funny thing is, I don't actually own DS1. So it's being Steam shared, I think. My brother's trying to play it or something. Actually gonna ruin this run. Let me text him and see if he's trying to play this game. What is this weird, like, weird Steam countdown, dude? Yeah, the investment in the setup, yeah, buy my own copy of DS1. I have 2 minutes. It's saying I have 2 minutes of... Let me see if I can... Yeah, I actually did buy it. It's just I bought it on my brother's Steam account. I somehow don't think that's what's actually happening. I highly doubt he's trying to play DS1 right now. Okay, let me see what the fuck's going on here, dude. Maybe my other brother's trying to play it. This is so stupid. Someone said it's... Dude, I'm going to buy it right now. Fuck it. Oh, there it is. Yeah, it actually DC'd me, dude. There we go. All right, crisis averted. Run continues. Maybe it was like a Steam strategy to... You know, make me think someone else was playing the game, but they actually weren't, and I didn't actually have to buy it again. What a wild run this is so far. What a wild day of runs, dude. Just the hits we've taken, and having to buy DS1. It'd be legendary to have in the actual run. Yeah, I paid to win the version of the game where you have infinite iframes the whole time. People suggested for me to do that during the... When I did all achievements Elden Ring no hit, like the insane... Maybe not suggested, but... They're like memeing about the insane clickbait potential. Every time I get hit, buy a new game. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I own all the other games on this account, but... Yeah, Sekiro I do. ES3 I do. Yeah, that's why we need 8 Soul Spears, by the way, right there. We need to get 2 stacks of it. Because 4 is not enough. He's weak to Chrysomai. Well, he's not weak to it. It's just we deal a lot of damage. And so it looks like he's weak, but he's not. So our damage is crazy. It's Demon's Souls Remake, Palma, yeah. Fashion acquired. Pretty sure I'm supposed to... Yeah. 41 intelligence. Valero. Oh, and... This one. He responded and asked if I was streaming. So I guess we were probably both playing it at the same time. But I guess Steam actually gives you like a little countdown before it DCs you from the game. It's interesting. That must be new. Definitely did not used to be like that. Used to be just you would boot someone off instantly. Rather than Gunrun 4. Yeah, probably, dude. I guess we don't need the bow here. What? That's why you gotta aim with mouse keyboard, dude. First official playthrough. Oh, what am I doing, you guys? Oh my goodness. Imagine if I lost the run to that. Just not paying attention at all. I was too busy looking at chat, seeing people's reaction to me killing Andre. Yeah, if he didn't try to scam you on the crest. Yeah, we save 20k by killing him. So yeah, he's gotta die. Especially on a run like this where we need a lot more souls on this run than the normal melee route, so. Fuck you, Sif. You fucking asshole. Oh, I hate that. I just hate that Sif does that. Like, oh yeah, I just got crippled, so now I'm gonna cancel my recovery animation. And then I'm gonna blast you with this weird off-timing attack. Crystal Soul Spear plus normal Soul Spear. Set up for Elden Ring is Iron Balls, of course. Iconic arena, yeah, true. Now, I was talking about earlier, I saw a tweet. Someone was basically saying that Papper Demon was a good fight. And then, to you know, it's fine for someone saying that, but then what really got me was that most of the replies were agreeing with it. Yeah, no, this is a boss arena, dude. You're damn right it is. Black JPEG boss arena. Why would you do that right there? Fucking psycho. I love sorcery, though. Hush. Might as well level up. I guess he stopped playing DS1. I don't blame him, dude. I wasn't streaming. That's probably how long I'd play DS1 for as well. Like 15 minutes and then it's and then it's done. That's actually really funny. Like, wait, why the fuck am I playing this again? Yeah, joke's on me, though. I'm the one who bought the game twice, so. I just warned you already beat DS1, though. Not sure which ones he's beaten. Definitely Elden Ring, at least.
Thank you.
I have two brothers and a sister. I'm not sure if I'm going to do another, like if we should, you know, if I do no-hit this, if we continue through Sekiro today, or if I would do that tomorrow. I'm excited for my camera to get here, dude. I really hope that the setup goes smoothly, because I know that it definitely might not. Weirdo, why are you swinging at me, dude? But yeah, so maybe we'll be back on YouTube again tomorrow. Is what I'm saying. Then we can continue this run. It would be nice to get the God Run 3 while the streams are on YouTube, because that'll make the YouTube video look better, because I can just make the stream here look way better. So that's a nice little bonus. Opinion on Quaileg? I think Quaileg's okay as a boss fight. I think it's okay. I feel like, yeah, if I did that on Twitter, I don't know. I don't like that. Twitch is better at the viewer experience. Is what I would say Twitch is better at. Really? Is that not... God damn it. Twitch, I would say, has a better viewer experience probably overall. And I think some people were saying too is, you know, the Twitch culture is different. It's definitely not for everybody. You know, the emotes that are over there and like the memes that people do and all this stuff. So I guess that's probably the main thing. I'm which is true. Like that's definitely true. The UI on Twitch is like, I would say it looks better, and like, it's nice having the colors in the chat. That's why the truffle extension for YouTube's decent, but I wish YouTube would just spend a little bit of effort there. And I think that'd make a huge difference, because when I was first talking about starting a stream on YouTube, the number one thing people were saying that they were concerned about was just the chat not being good, you know? So if they would just make it decent, that would be really good, I think. I think, where do I normally walk to? Here? I should probably take the hat off, but... Oh, the Insta. Yeah, and I guess one thing that Twitch probably does better too in terms of like a streaming site, you know, I guess one thing for discoverability of streamers is that when people go onto Twitch, they're looking for a stream, right? Whereas on YouTube, the streams are kind of like hidden away. You wouldn't just go and there's going to be like streamers recommended, that I've noticed at least. So I guess, yeah, that's probably another thing. But yeah, no, but it, yeah, it does recommend streams and stuff. I guess if someone's looking for a stream, I don't know if there's like some tab for it, or if there is, it's probably hidden away. I don't know. And there we are. Okay, well, so today, what were we on runs today? So we did no hit Bloodborne, Sekiro, and DS1, all of them once. I got hit twice in DS1, so that puts us at 3 for 5. And I got hit once in Bloodborne. I got hit twice in Bloodborne, so we were 3 for 7 today. Yeah, that's you know, it's not terrible, but it's kind of not good enough. But yeah, I guess we'll continue with Sekiro tomorrow. And then hopefully we can get a run that's through these first three games and at least start getting somewhere. All right, welcome back, you guys. So yesterday, we ended after I did DS1. So we now hit Bloodborne, we now hit DS1, and we're moving on to Sekiro. All right, here we go, dude. But then I'm going to stream both days on the weekend, so probably, you know, split those between YouTube and Twitch. And my camera should be coming either to... Well, hopefully it comes today, but I think it's supposed to come tomorrow. What got me into no hit running? I saw no hit run of DS3 on YouTube after I had, like, quit the game halfway through. And I don't know. I don't remember exactly what I thought, but I was super impressed by it. And then I also kind of thought, like, oh, I wonder how I would do if I tried that. This fight's scary, dude. You know, if you're doing a no-hit run in a single game, then usually the opening boss is not scary at all because, you know, you're in the first couple minutes of the run and it doesn't matter if you get hit, but when you're doing that boss a couple hours in, it's a lot different. Especially that one, because I find the grass kind of obstructs the view sometimes. Distinguish parries and blocks. You can just tell by the particle animation and the sound. It's not really intuitive. That's why I'm actually not a fan of the no-hit rule set in this game at all. I think no damage runs work a lot better in this game, but that's the main reason when the game came out, I did no damage runs on it and not no hit runs, where it kind of like half the no hit community did no hit, but God Run 3 is no hit, so that's what we're doing. Only reason I'm doing this rule set. Bloodborne is, yeah, I get it's scary because of shadows. You know, I was looking back at, so on my stream PC, I have a bunch of the old splits from like a bunch of old runs that I routed and runs that I did as well. 2021, I had routed Dark Souls 2 SO1 plus 0, no hit all bosses. And man, that's a cool run, dude. I'm definitely thinking if I have time this year, I would love to go back to that, but I'm not sure if I will. That would undoubtedly be at least one of the hardest runs done ever in the Souls games, if not the hardest even. But the base NG version of it is definitely possible. I can't, like, I don't know. I remember testing out some of this stuff for the Master Run ES2, which is SO1 plus 0, NG plus 7. And I don't know. I couldn't figure out how to do some of the things consistently, like Skeleton Lords, man. On level 1 plus 0, the Ivory King, you know, the battle phase of Ivory King is already
Very tricky. DS2L bosses harder than DS3L bosses? I would say probably. The fights aren't as complicated, but I mean, some of them are, though. So yeah, I would say it's objectively harder. Dude, the game fucking didn't lock me on there somehow. Oh, that was horrible. That's crazy, dude. Because I hit the lock on button, and I was right in front of the guy, and it just doesn't fucking lock me on. Luckily, I didn't panic, and I just, you know, I faced my character in the right direction, and just timed the parry correctly, but... This game sometimes, dude, is just horrible. Like, it's... I find it... It's sometimes worse than the other Souls games in terms of the controls. I really need to make a cooldown on that God Run command. Didn't really execute that super well, but... I'll probably play Liza P. I'm not sure if I'm gonna play it immediately when it comes out, or... It's very possible that I don't have this run completed by then, and I would rather complete this run before doing anything else. Okay, we got Makiri. I have lost a run before by forgetting to get it.
Yeah.
Wow, that was honestly a horrible fight. Yeah, parrying the lightning counts as a hit because you still take damage. Or it's not, you're not parrying the lightning, you're getting hit by it, so. Yeah, that was really, I played that very poorly, dude. And at least I managed it well once we were in the corner. Because that's, you know, that's really tough sometimes when you just can't see anything. But I made like several mistakes there. Luckily, wasn't a big deal. I'd love to just get, you know, even if we don't end up getting the run, I'd love to get one decent attempt on my intended order like this, you know? And actually having a good shot at getting the run. Artist section and Skiro, probably this one. If you're talking non-bosses. But yeah, this run is basically all about the boss fights. Guy tried to shoot me when he wasn't even aggro to me and he was trying to shoot me. I wonder what time period was this game meant to take place in, dude? Like, why do they have fucking spear guns? Why do they have that? With perfect accuracy. Like, yeah, surely it's 2010. I mean, that would explain how their guns are so good. No underground fish. Oh my god, dude, I didn't even know what that was right there. I thought, I don't even know, dude. I thought there was like some magic shit coming at me. Why would I just randomly get an emblem right there? And so at that part, I'm always, it should be relaxing and stuff. It's like, oh yeah, we're just waiting here until the elevator comes. Nope. Gotta look for the ground fish. I've stopped referring to Dragonlore and Elden Ring as Plusy. I never did that. So you can't stop something you never started, but. Lucidaxix, dude. I can turn up the music if it's too quiet. If people want me to, but there we go. Slightly turned up. cow? Is that a giraffe? Yeah, I don't know. That's a good question. Well, the name is Long-Armed Centipede Giraffe. So, I don't know if that really means anything. Really interesting. When I came back to Sekiro, you know, the game came out in 2019, and I hadn't played it until mid this year when I started preparing for God Run 3. Yet the Snake Eyes grab attack, I still that was one of the only attacks in the game that I remembered absolutely perfectly. And without any de-rusting, I just remembered how to parry that perfectly. I guess it's probably because I fought that enemy so much. And it's such a unique attack that I just remembered it, but it's such a counterintuitive timing on that grab. That you wouldn't think that it's like, oh yeah, that's an attack you remember perfectly. Which do I think would be more difficult? All bosses God Run 3 or level 1 God Run 3? Easily all bosses, honestly. And the other all bosses runs are not pushovers either, so like easily all bosses would be much more difficult. Even just think about the length, it would be like several times the length of level 1 God Run 3. You're still kind of doing all the same stuff, but your damage is lower. You might have to do some different strats, whereas doing all bosses means you're adding a lot of extra content rather than just kind of changing how it goes. Well, RL1 is Rune Level 1, which is the Level 1 class in Elden Ring, or what people call Level 1 in Elden Ring. All bosses, Elden Ring, I mean, all remembrances. No, I mean all bosses. I mean, you know, since I don't run Sekiro, I'm not sure, but I'm not sure if people consider all bosses in Sekiro to be all memories or, you know, actual all bosses. But I imagine it's all bosses in Sekiro also means, like, every boss and mini-boss. Atrocious ape fight, dude. I play it perfectly, but just such bad RNG. Your posture doesn't get broken if you parry perfectly. Except there's one instance on Armored Warrior where you do. I don't know why it's like that, but... Here we go.
Sekiro yo. Yarenu ka.
I honestly, I really messed up that last that last little mortal draw on Ishin there. I don't know why I locked off. I probably shouldn't have, but worked out. Definitely not my cleanest Sekiro run, but it got the job done. On to Dark Souls 3. DS3 is not my most comfortable run. You would think it would be since I've played it so much, but you can pretty much assume that the order of the games I go in is from, you know, least comfortable to most comfortable. So Dark Souls 3 being in the middle means it's not my most comfortable, basically. Yeah, Dark Souls 3 is definitely a scary no-hit run. The bosses are the hardest, and then also, it has the hardest running section, so that's why it's game 4 for me. Even though when I initially thought of doing multi-game runs, I always thought DS3 would be last, just because of how much I've run it. And, you know, I've done a lot of Dark Souls 3 tournaments as well, and I usually do well in them. I know how to handle the pressure when I'm playing this game pretty well. I've just done it over and over and over again, but DS2 is a bit more comfy, and then Demon's Souls is a bit comfier than that, and Elden Ring's last because I've just been playing it so much lately, and if I did this run 2 years ago, then probably DS3 actually would be last, because that was at a point where I was playing it all the time. Yeah, let's see if my keyboard inputs are weird here. It looks okay. Yeah, if you don't have Durazno in DS3, when you're trying to use keyboard while you have a controller plugged in, it can really mess with the directions of your W key.
Ah!
don't know, but actually, if you look at Dino's stats for when he was attempting Godwin 3 and his percentages at the games, I think DS3 was actually his highest. Yeah, see, this is probably where the, you know, the not straight W could have a big effect if it happens. So before the next time I run DS3, I need to make sure I get that installed. Because I wouldn't want to be throwing like a bad firebomb there. That's really bad. Oh, extra fire resin there. I don't know if I've ever actually gotten that before, because usually I don't bother to pick up what they drop, but time to watch my first casual Elden Ring. I didn't do most of it on stream, so no, you can't watch the whole thing, but like obviously like, I understand how Souls games work though at this point. Off that video. Yeah, maybe. I'm actually gonna get this in case I need to go get some extra skulls. Yeah, definitely wouldn't mind getting the storyteller staff, but it seems like the storyteller staff is saved for practice runs only. Speaking of Skyrim sex mods, dude, you know what's great to see? That MXR Mods is uploading again with Starfield. You love to see that, dude. Guys are being relentless, dude. I almost wonder if DS2... Like, there's so many games that I think I could put at game 4. You know, kind of all of these three games now, and even all the four. The four that are up... I mean, including this one, like, they could really be in any position. For games 4 to 7. It probably doesn't really matter what order they're in. Okay, this guy can have a meme where he turns the wrong direction and aggroes to you. Let's see if he does it. He did not. But based on, you know, the game order and stuff, it's kind of the illusion that we're halfway through right now, even though we're not.
Pretty big. Ashen One.
Well, zips don't just make the run shorter. They, you literally skip every boss. You don't have to fight a single boss if you use zips, right? I really messed that up. Now Red's going after me, of course. I don't have time for this. Oh, it's so tempting to go for that. If I was only doing a DS3 run, I'd probably go for that, but not on this. I just want to make sure I get some good spacing from this guy so it doesn't cut me off. Bad fight. Good phase two RNG though, I guess. It's kind of funny, the strat I was using before, I don't know if I messed up or something, but, you know, just running on the right side for that enemy. I actually got hit when I was doing a practice run the other day while doing it, which I didn't think was possible. I just started backstab there now instead of trying to run past and have, like, some sketchy out space.
Ashen One.
Oh, might seem like we're doing a sorcery run when we buy all this stuff, but we actually buy it all so that he gives us this ring.
Farewell, Ashen One.
Yeah, these routes that I'm doing are honestly really good multi-game routes. I wouldn't suggest them necessarily for people doing like a single game run, but for multi-game, I think it's worth kind of being extra safe on some of these things, and yeah. It seemed like it was less than 10 proper attempts at it, dude. That's what it seemed like, but I'm not actually 100% sure. Which is wild. Like, nobody gets runs that quickly, dude, on their first no-hit run. But yeah, of course, Sorcery Elden Ring's it's a different type of run than just like a DS3 any percent or something. Especially when all the strats I found were just basically god tier. Wulnir Vape does definitely count as a hit, yes. So yeah, this is actually now the second time that I've been in game 4. Or at least, it's the second time that I've no-hit Bloodborne, Sekiro, and DS1 all in one one run. Well, very tame. About the skulls, right? I need to make sure. This would be really bad if I didn't. Just wondering, I thought I normally got to 30, maybe 33 here is right. I could use my fire resin here the extra fire resin that I got. I guess I will. I'm not even sure if it would save a single hit, but. You don't really have to do this. If I was doing just a run of DS3, I would never kill the giant. But we do on this just, again, extra safety. Yeah, death by manicure, dude. Welcome to Dark Souls, where you can poke something in the foot for an hour and it dies. Okay, here we go. If I go for this, I have to watch out for the guys in the back because they won't aggro to this. Okay. So for the Godrun 3, I do this way more safely than I normally would, where I wait for each deacon to get back into the crowd before I go for another kill. The reason is the way you get hit on this boss is by, you know, throwing a skull and going for a kill where, you know, there's a deacon that's far away that doesn't actually go after the skull because the range isn't actually that good. Yeah, Pyromancy is decent here, but the problem is that it kills a lot of them, and you actually don't want to kill a lot of them. I actually consider doing a Pyromancy route for Godrun 3 for DS3. Just as good, and they're way more efficient, so I think I can go for this. So there's two killed. We're going to wait for two to funnel back in. There's one. So let's wait for this last guy to funnel in. He might have spawned on the backside. Oh, there he is. And I did the master run, which is level 1 plus 0, NG plus 7. This fight is unbelievable. It's so painful, it's insane, dude. You know, with the setup that you can get on that, you don't really have enough damage to just even kill the small deacons. Basically, the strat I used was just poison mist through the wall. And then you had to do that like 5 times or something to get phase 2 going. Okay, I think that guy's back in the crowd. So we're going to bring him halfway up and then we'll kill the last one. Yeah, this is one of those fights that everyone's always surprised on no-hit runs that it's like honestly one of the least consistent bosses, but after you just watch it once, it's like, oh, that makes sense. Thank you. The guy kind of dove right into the crowd as I like went to run up to him. I shouldn't have done an R1 there because I could have gotten a backstab, which would have been not ideal. Because then it would have, like, backstabs, it kills the guy and then swaps the orb, but you're still stuck in that animation. So I definitely should not have done R1 there, but I didn't. At least I didn't get a backstab, so it's fine. So might as well get this bonfire. But see, yeah, so like when I come into the dungeon here past these enemies, I have low health already. And so they would need to drain me for a long time to actually start draining my actual HP. But with this route of getting through here, they just don't drain you. So I might be the only one that does no hit runs that counts the jailer drain like that, but I think it makes the most sense. Yeah, Rykard is better than Yorm as like a cinematic fight and a gimmick weapon fight, but in every other category, I think Yorm is probably better. No, it's not. If you think you deal 50 damage to Yorm, then you don't know how the fight goes. Like, there is a totally viable, and in some cases, it's even faster than Storm, really, right? If I had a +9 Twinblade, the fight I just had right there would actually be slower than a +9 Twinblade fight. And it's not because Twinblades are super broken or something. It's just they designed them in a way that you can get a ton of damage off without needing the Storm Ruler if you just know what you're doing. Yeah, for people who don't know how Yorm works, though, without Storm Ruler, basically, so both of his arms are like weak points, and his head is also a weak point. And if you're fighting with melee, then you want to be focusing on his weapon arm, like the arm that he's holding the weapon in. And if you hit that for, I think it's around 1100 damage, then he'll stun. He'll kneel down, and then his head will just be exposed, which you can riposte, but you can also do, like, depending on the weapon, 4, potentially even 5 hits with a fast weapon before you riposte him. And then, you know, usually those combos, if you're talking Twin Blades with a decent build, you can easily deal 16,000 damage on his head. I think they probably wanted to make him, you know, simpler than they would have liked, probably because they figured that some people were just going to fight him and not pick up the weapon, and they didn't want them to get blasted for hours after not finding the weapon somehow.
What? Pradeem.
Huge 1 point of endurance. So 1,000. Be perfect. Blossom is definitely not needed here, but we have a bunch of extras anyways. Smartest Dark Souls Knight right there. And the Knight teleported in an elevator. Yeah, that'll happen a decent amount of time if you just run past him with him aggroing. But we have Slumber and Dragon Crest, of course, so. Or you can just cast Spook. Yeah, Hidden Body's got arguably a better version of Hidden Body, because, you know, you have kind of the more equivalent thing is when you get in the tower in Altus, I'm sure you guys remember the name, but you also have Assassin's Gambit, which is an Ash of War, which it makes you like invisible, but then also gives you the silencing effect. So it's like Hidden Body plus Slumbering in one. It's pretty damn good, dude. Yeah, Unseen Form, yeah. I always forget the name of it. Dark Souls 3 is definitely not the most unpleasant on the ears. That honor goes to Bloodborne, and there's no way that I could be convinced otherwise. I take off Slumbering here because I want to turn around this specific enemy up here. Because if you don't, then it's actually not good. Dunking your head is fine, but like I guess it could be okay for if you're asking for no hit, if you somehow have issues with the hands, because that's what the wax does, it makes you not get hit by those like curse hands. I guess it could be fine. I remember when I did all achievements no hit and there was a lot of collection I had to do in the archives. I'm pretty sure I had to do it. Not get hit on yeah, just running through that area like this, though, there's no reason to get wax head. Funny, if this game had the same hidden body as Demon Souls, where you couldn't recast it while it's active, so many of these strats would not be possible in the same way. Yeah, Assassin Gambit, you can refresh as well. And it also lasts way longer. Hidden Body, I think, lasts for what, like 15 seconds, maybe? Yeah, Gambit lasts what, like 30? We'll be right back. Yeah, that with this cheese, this fight becomes probably the hardest in any percent to being like a total joke like that, which is why everybody cheeses them. It'd actually be interesting to see the consistency at DS3 for the multi-game runners if that cheese didn't exist. Probably would be significantly lower, I would imagine. For me, it'd still be the same, Aggress, dude. Like, I've fought princes for... like, I've fought them a lot. This is the first run where I've actually started doing that cheese. I guess I've done other cheeses in the past, like, depending on the run, but... most of my time fighting princes is fighting them straight up, so it would be the same for me. Yeah, DS3 now hit is really nasty because you're at, like... princes and then Cinder as the final two bosses. Yeah, 121's about average with this route because of how slowly we do deacons, right? Okay, so what scares me the most about DS2 is probably the very start. Yeah, I switched the controller configuration for this game because this game actually has a dedicated auto-spread button, which is very nice. Honestly, haven't been using my makeshift auto-sprint in the other games at all because when we're on an actual run, it just, I think the risk is too high of, you know, me accidentally leaving it on for a boss fight and then trying to roll, but I die because I have my toggle sprint on. Yeah, you can tell how many times I've played this game based on how fast the character creation goes. It's true. Like, if you wanted to make a complicated character, then you'd probably want a macro.
Curses upon you, enough of this!
I kind of forgot, I was actually supposed to go do this stuff first. We start this class because it has the highest agility. Agility is what controls your iframes in this game, so we would like a decent amount of it. If you're good, you don't need it. Obviously, when you're doing SL1, you have to just get good at the game. Which is what makes SO1 no-hit in this game, like, so much more difficult than the other Souls games. Okay, this little running segment scares me.
see, like, this strat really just sketches the fuck out of me, dude. Kind of have to do it, though, because the way... So, since we're on vanilla, the way this ladder works is different. And we need to make sure we don't get chased here so that I can take my time and make sure this guy's not going to aggro. One of the negatives of running on vanilla DS2. So we had a situation with this guy last time, so I'm gonna just go rest before I go get the axe. And again, this is another example of a segment like this is not scary when you're just, you know, hitting only this game. But when you're, you know, 5 hours into a run, you gotta do this again. A little scary. Obviously, it's not safe at all. And I did actually lose a run while doing all achievements no hit in this game on game... Or not on game, on NG plus 2. Like the final NG cycle, I lost a run because of that. Not because of that strat, but because of the old strat. There we go, first try. Fight's usually scripted, but I messed up the opening. Yeah, people are wondering about that explosive wall. Like, the reason I don't count it as a hit, we're using a shortcut and I see it as self-inflicted damage, right? That's what I see it as. Yeah, you could see it as environmental, but I see it just more as a self-inflicted hit. But in the case that an enemy exploded a barrel and then I got hit by that barrel, I would count that as a hit. Like, I would reset on that. Not like that ever happens, but... It's just, yeah, I just do the rules that I think makes the most sense for a no-hit run, and I don't think... Some of the team hitless rules make perfect sense, or I just disagree with them, or whatever, then I just do what I want. It's like using Seppuku and Elden Ring, is the way I see it, right? Using an Ash of War that causes you to take a hit, like, it's clearly a hit, it's just... Self-inflicted hits usually aren't counted, at least I wouldn't count them myself, and so, that's... I see that kind of as a similar thing. Yeah, obviously on a no damage run, that would count, because we're taking damage. No damage run rule sets are a lot more intuitive. Because you're literally just doing what the title of the run is. You're doing a no damage run, but what a hit actually means is not super obvious sometimes, right? Yeah, no damage is all damage. If you take a single instance of damage, then the run's over. Doesn't matter what it's from. There are still some considerations, though, like, there's certain buffs that might decrease your HP in like, weird ways, right? Yashi is a good example, the Yashi sugar in Sekiro. But, it's not really dealing damage, but on no damage runs, the Yashi isn't allowed because... Which I agree with, to be honest, because it's decreasing your health.
I'll be around.
Yeah, the reason we kill her, yeah, is because she invades you later in the undead crypt if you don't, and so we kill her so that she does not. I keep thinking it's no commentary because no face cam. Yeah, I guess that's true. I'm just paying attention to the game, which can be hard to do sometimes, honestly. It can be hard about doing no-hit runs while streaming is that it's so easy when you're running these games to just not pay attention to stuff. And I, you know, in some of the games I can get away with it, but some of them I really cannot. Part of the reason why we played the original version of DS2 also is because you immediately get the key to enter this DLC from the start of the game, and you don't have to like go find it in the world or kill the Gulch Giants for this one.
It's so funny, dude. When I first started no-hit running DS2, I couldn't even imagine a no-hit run in a Souls game being easier than this one, but now that I come back to it after like quite a while of not doing DS2 runs and I see all the strats and compare it to Demon Souls and Dark Souls 1 and Elden Ring and stuff, it's just, wow, this run is way harder than I was giving it credit for back in the day. Like, there's all these really specific strats that we're doing here. Very precise execution. Yeah, we go into DLC though. We get Flynn's Ring, which is one of the best damaging rings in the game, and then we also get a bonfire setting.
I'll be a...
Come on, little frog boy. Let me kill you. Yeah, I guess it's just that I had done, like, I'd done so many runs in DS2 that, I don't know, I kind of just under... I guess I just kind of forgot. It is definitely a little tricky, I think, especially using this route. A lot of the older runners, they go with, older runners and they run Scholar, they go with the route that takes them through Seldora. And then they don't get Flynn's Ring, but then they would get a plus 10 rapier, and which kind of like offsets it. It's fucking flying, dude. It actually wasn't that scary, but it just it's because I managed my stamina badly, and he was just able to catch up. He's honestly in a good spot, but let's just wait for him to move. Oh, and he goes the wrong way. It was the scholar version of that game of this game that introduced the alluring trees. So you can't do that in this version. The trees make noise, but they just don't. I don't think they do anything. Honestly, Shrine of Amana's difficulty is so fucking overrated, dude. It's just people want to like blow by every area in the game like they do in, you know, DS1 or something. And so yeah, if you're trying to blow by the area, then it fucking sucks. But you just methodically go through. It's honestly one of the easiest run areas in the game, dude. Yeah, I guess with range specifically, but you don't even need range, dude, if you just know what you're doing. Come on, rotten bro. That slam attack is it kind of has deceptive range on it. So, I don't like to cut that one close. If I think I'm, barely outspacing it, I'd prefer to just roll it. I think at RTSR, honestly not worth trying to get it set up again. Probably the worst of the Rottens to not get Red Tearstone set up on. Yeah, it's because this one we used the Bright Bug on it, so it reduces some of the scaling of NG plus 3. And that one we don't use a Bright Bug, so it's like relatively the tankiest one. And then I missed the RTSR setup. When I did all achievements no hit in this game, I think I had to kill 20 Rottens on that route. Yeah, basically what killing the Rottens does is prevents you from having to do the all the old souls. It's basically just like the quickest way to farm them up the soul memory so that we can go through Shrine of Winter. And yeah, I'm pretty sure I had to kill like 20, at least 20 Rottens on that run. Because the 1 million soul memory requirement scales up on the NG cycles. I think it goes up by a million each time or something like that. And if I'm not mistaken, all of the soul memory that you get has to be on that NG for the Shrine of Winter to actually open up. So it was like, it was for the first NG cycle, and then the next NG cycle, it was like fucking 8. And the last one, it was like 10. Like, I don't remember exactly, but it was a lot of Rottens, dude. We get to 99 agility here. Yeah, I personally go with pretty low agility throughout this run. If you wanted to be safer, if you wanted to do this route and be safer, you probably just sacrifice a bit of endurance for more iframes.
Gone so soon.
I'll just buff it to be safe. I don't remember if I'm supposed to. Pretty sure I don't. All right, one of the negatives of running vanilla is coming up. Should we do this properly? What a huge mistake I just made. Not sure why I tried to rush that. Make sure I get the headshot. Yeah, luckily that knight didn't just go like hide away in the corner, which he sometimes does when you miss that shot. Thank you. Like that RNG there. Boss is most RNG scary in this game. Probably, I immediately think of Throne Duo, and I guess probably the lead up to Giant Lord is honestly really sketchy. So probably those two. Can every bot stock just be strafed? Well, this game has a lot of positional dodges. You know, if you're watching somebody who has thousands of hours in a game, it's probably going to look easy. Not that that strat in particular is super hard to execute, but that is like a specific strat we do. That's not just his normal moveset. I get those comments all the time on the YouTube videos. It's like, oh yeah, I watch you kill this boss, and it's like, man, this looks so easy. And then they go do it themselves, and it's like, what the fuck just happened, dude? A lot of people say also that the game looks like it's in slow motion when they're watching it, which makes sense, to be fair. Yeah, the bow does insane damage, and the funny thing is too, I haven't even upgraded it. It's not that it's plus zero, it's that we picked up this bow pre-upgraded in the first DLC, so that's like another benefit of doing the Shelva route. You just get a plus seven longbow. That's what I'm saying, like these areas are insanely, if you come in here with the right idea and you just go methodical, it's just trivial to get through these, man. As long as you don't try to just gun it past every enemy like in the other Souls games you can do. Yeah, Rapier is good in DS2 because it attacks quickly, and it's also got that 140 counter rating. The earlier Souls games are kind of all about counter hits. A lot of weapons have really good counter damage, so it's not just the Rapier. There's plenty of other weapons that could do the same thing there. But we actually don't use the Rapier for the rest of this run, though. We use the weapon that we just got. You see that 150 counter rating? It's a thing that speedrunners do a lot, but I honestly haven't seen many no-hit runners do this kind of route where you switch from the Rapier, but it makes sense because we're only at plus four in the Rapier right now. And you can't upgrade the key. And that plus zero, the key definitely does way more damage than the Rapier. Not that the Rapier is bad to use for the rest of the run, it's just, it's better. Yeah, some of the Gray Lances are at 160. Which, I guess, I don't know for sure, but probably what that 160 means is, like, that's the damage multiplier on counter hits. Although I'm not 100% sure on that. Go too far here. Good. Wait for the diagro. And this is why I killed Lysia earlier in the run, because she invades through here. And if you messed up this strat, like I just did, and Lysia's chasing after you, then that's a serious problem. Like, you wouldn't be able to just sit here and wait. And so we killed this guy to spawn the mages. This is another section that is significantly worse in vanilla. Scholar, you just run past the boss here and you just grab the fog gate and that's it. Vanilla, there's a million enemies here. Watch the spear. I really like the segment of DS2 where you go from, you know, Drangleic all the way to Vel'Staht. Because when you think about it, I used the same RTSR setup that entire time. Like, it was the same damage that I took from the hammer when we first got into the entry of Drangleic. We carried that all the way. It's always nice when the, you know, there's not a big break in segments of a run. Like, you're just constantly running through stuff. Oh my god, dude. I basically talked that into existence right there. I actually iframed his flight there, because that has a hitbox when he flies to the wall. So I actually iframe that fucking attack, dude. That's crazy. I've never even done that before. That's what I was... I said I talked that into existence because earlier we were talking about the fights where it's like the most scary RNG. And yeah, Guardian Dragon, you know, could either be trivial or can be like that. Yeah, this is an area that, if you're doing speedruns, this area is better in vanilla. But for no hit, it's probably worse, because we just have to kill a lot more enemies here. Normally, in Scholar, you only have to kill two enemies, but here we have to kill, like, everybody. One thing that's nice about this area, though, is it's kind of like the relaxing area of DS2 for no hit, since you're kind of... You know, there's not a ton of danger here. You're kind of just shooting everybody down, preparing for the final three bosses. Tragic if it all ended here. I guess so, but when you think about it, we're 6 hours in. This run is about 10 hours, so there's still, we're like just over halfway through, even though it might seem like, oh yeah, we're on game 5 and, you know, all this great stuff. We still have a significant amount of time left on this run, so. Magic for these giants. That is the exact thing that scares me so much about this fucking area, dude. Exactly what he did. Played it well, though. so good. Yeah, that's terrifying, dude. Because the issue with when he does that is if he doesn't time, like if he times it weirdly with the, you know, the explosion thing, then like you could just get killed, you know, just straight up. You try to run away and then, well, you're not going anywhere because this thing's coming at you. Yeah, luckily the timing worked out okay, but I actually meant to go back there and test strats out for that section. I guess I never did. Because yeah, that on every single run I've ever done, that section's been just terrifying. Yeah, not my cleanest DS2 run to this point, you guys. Like, I think I kind of maybe like DS2 game 4 better. There have been at least 2 chances where I could have easily died so far. Obviously, we still got, like, the hardest boss plus another, like, slightly tricky boss to end it off. Nice. Love that RNG when Nishandra just runs straight up to me. A lot of runners don't like that. They like to just pick her off with a bow, but I definitely prefer the faster RNG like that. Here we go. Yeah, that was definitely one of my most scuffed DS2 runs probably ever, but did make it through. All right, now Demon's Souls is definitely the outlier game for me as the final four because of, you know, DS3, DS2, and Elden Ring, I have like thousands of hours in each of them, but Demon's Souls, I have not so much. So we'll see what happens here. But yeah, I think I probably have like 160 hours in Demon's Souls at this point. Yeah, so this is the longest run in the God Run for us. It's an hour. It's like roughly an hour 50 minutes. All right, here we go.
Ah!
We're gonna simply wait until this guy kills everybody. I guess having two spice by now is normal, but it kind of seems low, I guess. Oops, I'm gonna go back here. That boss is, it doesn't look scary, but it's another one of those cases like the Deacon's boss where, like, oh man, this boss is so fucking easy, except there's 100 projectiles flying across the room, and that makes it a little sketchy. That was pretty well played. Hit most of my firebombs there. We get 7 of these, and then elixir.
Your souls.
The gods demand repentance.
Okay, here's where I've lost runs before. It was because I was using a bad strat, but... Whoa. I didn't just roll there. What the hell? I'm gonna be patient on this part. Wait for the guy to path across here. Don't really want to mess with him. Probably out of anything in Demon's Souls, I'm the most scared of this at boss fight. Luckily, it's purely execution. Like, if it goes wrong, it's your own fault, but it's, you know, it's not the simplest execution. Alright, here we go. Not gonna lie, when I actually get the God Run 3, dude, it's gonna be such a boring YouTube video. Like, whether it's right now or, you know, in the future, it's just because when we get to this point in the run, I'm just focusing. Like, I'm not talking, really, and that's not necessarily the best content, but... Yeah, the London special, dude. That's basically what this area is. We run around just shibbing everybody. All right, we are past Fool's Idol. We usually get to 29. Oh, I must have forgotten to pop some souls or something. There's no way that's right. 29 or 30 here is what we're supposed to reach. The magical sharpness, thief ring. Now this running section also a little scary. 20 and 32. All right, here we go. Before I do anything, let's make sure that I get Poison Mist learned. We have enough magic to wield it, I think. I think we got everything. Jesus, dude. I look away for 1 second and then this guy's fucking barreling down on me. We're gonna be doing a strat up here that I haven't done that many times. Where we use the solar main for the Garg here. Hopefully it's a good strat because I've only done it like 3 times. And it's worked perfectly every time, but 3 is not a lot of times for something. Thank you. Yeah, I wasn't a huge fan of that lock on, but. Yeah, the slow runner strats. I'm certain there's a faster way to set up Clever Rat here. It's just I don't know it. Cheesing begins. Yeah, we might do GeoGuessr, but I honestly, I'm probably not going to. Not on a live run. Well, it's like Storyteller staffs, except this damage is like a 20th as good. What's nice though about doing these types of cheeses in this game is that enemies don't care if you make sound. So like I could smack the ground here and they still don't turn around for some reason. A second guy should be coming any second though. Beauty of the strat. Okay. Now we let the poison do its job. Poison does 900 damage, and I think each proc is 3 minutes, right? Yeah, if we no-hit this today, we're going to Elden Ring, dude. Can't do the Nihil poison strat. Well, I mean, you could, but Team Hitless wouldn't accept that run. It's just whether that means anything to you or not. But yeah, obviously that's like completely just an arbitrary rule. If someone kills a boss outside the boss arena, in my opinion, on a no-hit run, I wouldn't think anything of it. I mean, it's not much different than what I just did right there. Gonna wait for my cloak to come back. This is what's kind of annoying, that you can't just like recast it when it's active. You have to wait. Actually, Diagra there, I think. Dude, he's actually trying to do a 5-head play and cut me off. Oh my god, dude. How do you not de-aggro there? That's insane. But he's really mad for some reason. How does he... Like, I don't even comprehend how he doesn't de-aggro there. That's insane, dude. Oh, it was a nice save, though. He can't see me, and he's still, like, fucking blasting in, dude. That's crazy. Okay, let's get Soul Arrow. Water. He was trolling right there, dude. Swap the spells. Thief ring. Dan, thanks, dude. Okay, 49 magic is what I'm supposed to hit. We can get 50, I think. I think 54 is right. Last time I forgot to cast Cloak here and then I died. So it was the last run I did, like a practice run of Demon Souls. Bro, I was talking to chat, totally forgot. Didn't cast Cloak, got swarmed by a bunch of enemies. It was actually one of these fuckers that killed me because I had to I was trying to evade the island enemies. I think the rest can just go in magic here, pretty sure. Now there is a particular tiny section here that I've been having some issues with, so hopefully that doesn't happen. The section I also meant, it's not even on this split, by the way. It's right before the Penetrator is the part that I was talking about. Okay, so this section, a little scary. And the issue I've been having is I keep locking onto the wrong enemy somehow. Like, I lock onto the assassin, but I'm trying to lock onto the other guy. Oh my god. Whoops. Never seen him throw a fucking firebomb before. Could you imagine if that fucking got me somehow? I'm just gonna wait for the cloak. Whee! I do have to go to the bathroom, but I'll do it after this any percent's done here. Imagine if we had Demon Souls Game 7 and then, like, this was the finale, dude. I guess it'd be good from a runner's perspective because then it's like, oh, once we get to a certain point, we just know we're done, but... Still got another game. I certainly could go to the bathroom right now. Again, I don't want to do GeoGuessr because I don't want to be taken out of the run, really. Yeah, this takes, like, 15 minutes, basically. After this, there's just Elden Ring left, if this goes okay. Yeah, I feel pretty good about Elden Ring, but there's certainly things I could get hit by. There actually was a run the other week in Elden Ring where I got to the third church. One of the mosquitoes followed me and actually, like, attacked me, dude. It didn't hit me because I forget how I dodged it. I'd never seen that before. I'd never seen a mosquito chase that far. I think I got iframes from the horse mounting or something is how I didn't get hit, but... It's like the fears from the all bosses no-hit run coming back, dude. The random mosquito hit in Limgrave. But like, the fights that I actually have to do kind of properly is Godric, Radahn, Goldfree, Fire Giant to a degree I have to get in on the opener, and then Horlu. So yeah, there's a few fights that I need to do properly. I think Goldfree is probably the longest legit fight, depending on, you know, RNG. Radahn could also, if he gives you a bad opening, which is really rare, but if he does, it's also really sketchy, man. I'm honestly just gonna... Like, I probably have enough damage right now, but I'm just gonna, like, make sure we easily have enough here. I've done this one time where we were at about this point, and I go to do my kill, and I ran out of FP after I casted my soul arrow. And so, like, yeah, that was not good. After we start this next proc, we can go in. All right, let me get this last cast off, and then... Should be good to finish him off here. Scumna, thanks for the donation, dude. Thanks so much, man.
Everlasting demon soul, whatever you have. Surely you have seen for yourself the pain and suffering that fills this world. But God is merciful, and so created the Old One. Poison to poison. You fool, put over.
Okay, there it is. Yeah, 151 is about how long that takes. Okay. We usually go with the pots. Actually, I should probably switch my controller configuration, but it probably doesn't matter. Too risky. I'm actually, you know what? I'm not even going to bother with the wet knife. I usually pick it up, but I'll just waste some extra time and go back to the blacksmith because I don't know. I'm a little bit scared of picking it up. I'm not going to lie. I feel like a dog could follow me in there or something. What? Oh, that's not good. Okay, I guess I do need to switch my controller. That should be good. There we go. The fucking like Xbox game bar popping up. I don't think Claw is a good idea, to be honest. I think you're much better off just, you know, spending a bit of extra money on a controller. That has back buttons. It's just better for you long term. That being said, I still Claw grip all the time, so probably take my own advice. But yeah, I guess if we do complete this right now, it would be by far the fastest God Run 3 that's been done. I'm pretty sure. I don't know exactly how long Bushido's run was, but I don't think it was faster than like 13 hours. But yeah, whether we get the run right now or not, like the routes that we use are for the most part, they're pretty efficient. I do a lot of things that are really slow. Obviously, like the poison cheeses and Demon Souls take a lot of time. But for the most part, the runs are decently efficient. They're not fast and they're not as quick as I would do them if I was just doing a singular game. You guys remember that time where I basically exited the zone too early for this invader and then he chased me all the way around Limgrave and I couldn't go on my horse? Imagine that happening now. I forget what run that happened in. His spray is a debuff. As we talked about earlier, debuffs aren't hits.
Maybe I'll be the best nut ever.
For the top right corner, I just like wrote a quick program for it. Did I say top left? I meant top right. I don't know what I said. Not gonna take off the pants, dude. I like the pants. We take off the pants later. Once I get blue dancer charm, then we take off the pants to get the optimized weight for damage. Okay, so I just get the one of those here. I think that's it.
Repentance.
No, the Eye of Sauron thing does actually count as a hit if you take damage from it, because it deals damage and status. So yeah, you have to completely avoid the damage there. Still lots to go through here, man. I think we still got the whole game to no hit. You know, I thought this setup was going to, like, be kind of nice and relaxing when I made it to Game 7, but it's honestly the opposite, dude. I just want to start, like, fighting shit. It's actually not the first time I've made it to the final game, but it is the first time making it to the final game being Elden Ring. Okay, setup's basically done.
I'll give you the best nut ever.
Always kiss the tip right there. Always left-hand your balls and always kiss the tip. That advice will never fail you. You know, it's always funny to me, and this happens to me as well, but I guess a good example is when I was watching the end of Potastic's run last week. I don't know if this is the case for everybody, but I get so much more nervous watching other people than just doing it myself. It's insane, dude. Like, it's so funny reading the chat right now. Everyone's, like, freaking out. Do I get all strength here? I think so. Let's see, why not? But yeah, when I watch people at the end of their runs, dude, it's definitely, it's just different. It's different when you have no control over what happens versus when you do.
Of it.
Well done. Something to mark.
Wasn't such a huge fan of that positioning right there. Where these souls came from. I'll use them. Okay, so we put him into phase two, Flame Garmy Strength, sleep. It should be pretty simple.
Maybe I'll give you the best nut ever.
the insane, like, a DS2 baby jump right there, dude. Luckily, I could have just fast traveled out if I missed that, which is what I was, like, a millisecond away from doing. That was a little questionable, dude. I guess the phalanx just didn't fire until, like, I thought I whiffed a hit or something, but I didn't. Just the phalanx didn't fire. Yeah, that's bizarre, dude. I haven't actually seen that before. Maybe I just wasn't facing him for long enough, but that's why I hate using phalanx, dude, because it's so, it could be so inconsistent.
Demand repentance!
Maybe I'll give you the best nut ever.
And there we go. No problem, dude.
Maybe.
Easy.
I'll give you the best nut ever.
Always left-hand your balls, you guys. That's the secret.
Oh my god, dude. That's so shit.
No problem,
shit.
Dude.
That is so shit. That is such a garbage.
There it is, dude.
Oh my god.
The gods demand repentance. Cough up your coin. All of it.
Not too bad. Look at all that purple, dude. Beautiful.
The gods demand repentance. Cough up your coin. All of it. The gods demand repentance.
Dude, the patches.
Cough up your coin.
Oh,
going on like a monologue
god,
here, dude.
Dude, that's so shit.
Yeah, there it is.
That is so shit. That is
yeah, that was a pretty clean Elden Ring.
Oh my god.
Overall, I would say this run was actually pretty clean. DS2 is probably the most sketch out of everything, but even the situations we got, I handled it pretty well, so not bad at all. Yeah, I got it a bit faster than I thought, you know, since coming back to attempting it. Like this was, I guess, the third stream back attempting this, but it's not bad. So now I guess we're going to have to figure out what to do. Because I was, you know, I was prepared to do this run for another couple of weeks, but... So yeah, this is by far the fastest that this run's ever been done, I'm pretty sure. Like, I think this is probably around 6 hours faster than the next fastest. Obviously, speed doesn't actually matter, but it's nice to see the efficiency coming through. Yeah, I wonder if Hunter's gonna be upset that I didn't have Cam for this, dude, because it is kind of funny that I get the run in the 2 days, 2 days out of the last year that I do not use Cam, and I get the God Run 3 on it. So... Whoops. I'm kind of curious to see the run stats. As I expected, we didn't do enough attempts of it to actually get a good gauge of what my percentages are in the games. Here's the nice spreadsheet that Ara made. 18 streams, dude. If that's accurate, that's fucking decent, dude. It's pretty funny that I got this on YouTube, huh? At least, you know what? The benefit of YouTube is that the fucking video is going to look sick, right? Because YouTube streams just look so much better, and I don't locally record these, so... I don't even know what to do next, man. There's a lot of runs I want to do. I was literally talking earlier this stream about level 1 plus 0 all bosses no hit in DS2 because I came across those splits earlier on the hit counter that I saw. Like I was just looking through the splits randomly. I'm like, oh man, I have the splits for that still. But obviously Elden Ring runs are going to be happening again. Bow only all bosses is the run that probably most people have been waiting for. So that's going to be happening. Anyways, I'm going to call it for today, guys. There we go. We simply win. Honestly, even if I had Cam on during this, you guys wouldn't have missed much. I was just literally sitting here with a straight face and just looking at the game. And my reaction after getting the run was probably... I probably looked exactly like how I sounded. I was just like, yep, there it is. As I do for every single run at this point. But yeah, dude, the YouTube crowd is eating good today, man. I've done like, what, 6 YouTube streams? And then one of them's been the God Run 3 completion. Crazy, man.